Yesterday was a memory, a might have been. The rock and roll never forgets, forgives or regrets.
Nothing comes easy.
I'm trying to get it all together now. Yesterday was your hair so long, an old love song, and a photograph of you singing the blues.
Nothing comes easy.
I'm trying to get it all together.
And then he said, wait for this, Anna. He said to her, look in your minestrone soup. Isn't it gorgeous?
Look in your minestrone soup.
There was a friendship ring in it.
Oh my gosh, how romantic.
Yes. Well, it would have been more romantic if it had been chicken broth. Because then she wouldn't have had to fish around to find the ring. But then he said to her, you are the most exquisite creature I have ever laid eyes on.
Oh!
If someone said that to me, I'd be theirs forever.
You are the most exquisite creature.
Get lost, dork.
Oh, well, see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Anna, I need to ask you something.
Well, you can get Clearasil at any chemist, Thomas.
Oh, what's on my face? Oh, that's a joke. Anna, I need you to be honest with me. And just because I'm your twin brother, I don't want you to be nice.
Good, I think you're a loathsome little toad anyway.
Yes. Right, I'll be direct with you. Do you think I've got a chance with Jody? Is that a yes or a no?
Are you serious? You are serious. Thomas, how could Jody possibly be interested in you? You're so arrogant. You love yourself.
Well, you've got to start somewhere.
Girls don't like guys that are too confident.
But I was reading in Dolly last month for a school assignment that what girls like most in guys is confidence.
Well, that's true.
Well, then?
A guy has to be confident, but not conceited.
There's a difference.
You see, there's your problem. You don't know the difference. Honestly, that dog in the chum commercial's got more personality than you.
Well, he's had training.
Oh, I suppose I shouldn't be so hard on you. You know, I keep forgetting you're at that difficult age.
We're twins.
Everyone knows that girls mature faster than boys. So even though I'm only 15 minutes older than you, I'm actually, say, 2 or 3 years ahead of you in emotional development. And Jody was born 5 months before us, so that makes her...
older than Bobby's last haircut.
Thomas, what Jody needs is someone really special. You know, some kind of wonderful romantic night to make her feel like a beautiful woman.
Right, so if a guy was to act confident but not conceited, and was to think of something really romantic, like, say, a specially catered for dinner for two?
Oh, yes, that'd be all right. Oh,
she'd go out with him.
Well,
I was listening to Zap FM before. They got this great new competition.
Thomas, to the stage number, man. They're playing Easy Street on the radio. I heard them call me.
Well, I'll listen to Zap in the kitchen.
Don't you want to hear old man, man?
No.
That was Easy Street by Bobby Rivers, out front of Stillwaters, a real classic from 72.
Classic.
I guess the only rockin' Bobby does these days is in a chair. Let's keep it moving.
See, he's really funny, isn't he? But he's got a really funny haircut, too.
It's that time of the hour again. If you want to win that fabulous dinner for two, catered for in your own abode, get onto those phones. Taking the 47th caller.
Oh, I'll never get through. Oh, hi, Anna. Is Doug around? I don't know. He might be in his room. I've got some fantastic news for him.
Oh, what?
Oh, no, I better tell Doug first. Can't wait to see his face. Doug!
All right, we've got Thomas Sumner on the line, and Thomas is our lucky 47th caller. How's it feel to win a romantic dinner for two, Tom?
Well, it...
Good on you, matey. Hold the line and we'll take your details. Tommy, where do you hear all the latest happening hits?
On the radio?
Yeah, bye.
Did you hear that?
Yes, I heard that. But listen, don't ask Jody out for a couple of days because, girls don't like guys that are too keen.
But I thought you said girls like guys who aren't afraid to admit they're interested.
Well, they do.
Well, then.
Oh, I can't find Doug and I've just got to tell someone. I've got us our best job yet.
Oh, what is it?
Well, you know that Zap FM where they play all the latest happening hits?
Ah.
They're having a dinner at home competition. Well, guess who's doing the catering? I wonder whose house we'll be at.
Right, now, let's just run through it one more time from the top. For luck. Tracy.
We, quickly and quietly walk in. Quickly and quietly light the candles. Quickly and quietly put the food on the table and disappear. Quickly and quietly.
And if Jody's getting bored? Doug.
We quickly and quietly lock the door. From the outside.
Yes. Very good work, men. Sorry this is a little bit unusual, but you are doing the catering and I just want everything to be perfect.
Well, it will, Thomas. Just believe.
I believe. I believe she thinks I'm a creep.
Oh, Thomas, if she thought you were a creep, she wouldn't have said yes.
Yes! You're absolutely right, 100%. What am I worried about? But I haven't asked her yet.
Go out with Thomas. But he's a creep. It's revolting, Anna. That's the grossest, office, most turgid concept I've heard of in my entire life.
So you wouldn't be interested then?
I'd be more interested in eating worms. I'd be more interested in drowning in rancid goat's milk. I'd rather be spat on by a Tibetan llama.
I'll lend you all my Harry Connick Jr. CDs.
Okay, then.
What a residency, man.
Oh, beautiful people!
Hey, Thomas, what'd she say, man, eh?
Well,
he hasn't asked her yet.
Oh.
Asked who what? No one, nothing.
Thomas has won a romantic dinner for two right here, man, and he's going to ask Jody.
A girl?
Trace and I are supplying the food.
Yeah. Gee, I hope the chicky babe's got a cast iron gut.
Big night, eh, man? Your first special date with that first special someone. Oh, yeah. I bet you're nervous. I was, you know. I was so nervous, I ordered a Hawaiian instead of a pepperoni. Good.
Yes, well, I'll make sure I don't do that.
Well, time out here, kid. Why don't you ask a professional to help you out here? You know, I can recall my big first romantic experience. I was scared. Confused.
Alone.
Well, you'd know that feeling, kid.
Ryan, if you're going to say something, could you at least make it positive?
Oh, sure, anything for you, Chicky Pie. Because the Wayne is a giver. The Wayne is a sharer. Tell you what I'm going to do. My cousin Benito plays violin at my uncle Vinny's restaurant. I will set up, wait for it, a serenade. Forget it. How little you know, Zitface. Violin is the instrument of love. Amore and more amore.
Well, it is a romantic idea.
And the chicky babes love it.
Right, we'll have one. How much?
No, it'll be our shout. We'll set aside $50 from the catering budget.
$50 for the violin? Cheeky babe. For that, you might get a bit of a fiddle yourself.
How many clothes you'll have nothing left to fiddle with?
Boss, ask her now.
Yeah, man, don't be scared.
I'm not scared.
Oh, this is getting me where I live here. This poor kid, he's just about to step on the welcoming mat of life and he's too scared to wipe his feet. Tell you what, kid, I'll ask her for you.
Wayne, no way! Get back in here! Get in here!
All right, what's the hair?
Look, I'm going to ask her myself. As a matter of fact, I'm going to ask her right now.
Mm-hmm. And then, Brad told Craig to tell Amanda that he wants to take Joy out.
Yes! Oh, hi, Thomas.
Hi, Jody. Well, by then...
Ah, no, Thomas, I think Tracy wants him in the kitchen.
Jody, look, I know you don't like me very much, but...
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, well, anyway, the thing is, well, I've won this specially catered for dinner for two, and I thought if you weren't doing anything, I thought maybe you'd like to join me for it.
Okay.
I can totally understand if you... What did you say?
I said yes.
Trace, I need to speak to you for a minute.
I thought I wasn't allowed to speak.
That's only after Jody arrives. Well, it's sort of like, it's kind of... Well, you know, Trace.
Oh, sorry.
You see, I want to make a good impression on Jody, but whenever Anna tells me what women want from men, I get the panic attacks. You know, sort of like when Bobby has to take a bath.
Yeah, sometimes it helps to get a more sophisticated woman's opinion.
Yes. I just don't know anyone like that. What do you think a woman wants?
Well, let's see. A woman wants a man who's independent, but not selfish.
I don't understand.
Oh, well, you see, understanding is very important.
Oh, well, I think I'm beginning to understand.
Don't be too presumptuous.
I might be wrong.
But indecisiveness is a real turn-off.
Excellent! Absolutely crystal clear in my mind. Glad we've sorted that one out. Anything else? No? Off you trot, then.
Where do you think you're going?
Oh, I don't care. Anywhere. This is so embarrassing. It's going to be a complete disaster.
Understanding, but not presumptuous. And decisive. Or was that indecisive? Oh, no, I can't decide. Now, is that good or bad? Oh, wow. Should I answer that or not? Did I tell you I was the 47th caller? Oh, yes, 47th. Not 48th, not 49th, not 50th. 47th, huh? I think it's very important for a man to be understanding nowadays, don't you?
I don't understand.
Well, when I say understanding, I don't mean...
I like a man who takes control. Someone who tells you what to do.
Pass me the salt. Now!
You don't have to be so rude, Thomas.
Is it just me or are women incredibly difficult to work out?
It's you. You're very immature. And that's why I'm here. I feel sorry for you.
Thanks a lot, Jody.
Oh, well, I can't take all the credit for it. Anna feels sorry for you too. In fact, so does most of Year 11.
Did Anna ask you to have dinner with me?
No, of course not. She bribed me.
Oh, well, that's just great, isn't it? Terrific. Anna tells me not to be patronising, and what does she do?
Help out poor Thomas, he's a loser.
Oh, I know how you feel. You know, the other day, Anna tried to tell me that a university study has proven that blondes are less intelligent than brunettes.
You'd have to be stupid to believe that.
Do you believe it?
No, that's terrible. I mean, I've always thought that you were much smarter than Anna.
Did you? Oh, well, I am a Leo.
I know. Yeah, and did you know that Anna's so hung up on this ozone layer thing, she won't even let me use hairspray?
You want to use hairspray?
No, no, not at all. But even if I did want to use hairspray, it's... Well, she wouldn't let me, you know? And I believe that it's very important for every person to be able to use hairspray, whether they're blonde or brunette.
Or redhead.
Point taken. Oh, yes, exactly.
That's very interesting. You know, Anna's my best friend in the whole world, don't get me wrong, but she even thinks she knows more about sex than me.
As if she could know more than a blonde.
What's that supposed to mean?
Point taken.
Exactly, you're right.
You know, Anna even thinks she knows more about sex than me. What a laugh.
Have you done it?
Have you?
I asked you first.
You know who has done it? Not Anna.
Not Anna.
You know, sometimes I feel like...
Fettuccine marinara. Here you are.
Oh, thanks. Looks delicious.
Good. Oh, well, bon appetit.
Don't touch that food, it's poisonous.
What? What are you talking about?
What do you call that, Trace?
It's parmesan.
It's Ajax. Oh. Yo, beautiful young lava.
What's wrong? Winnie the Punchetto is the name. Violini is my guy.
Why, nick off.
Oh, how did you know it was me?
Trace, I can't believe you do something so stupid.
What's going on down here?
Trace put Ajax on the fettuccine.
Oh, well, I've heard of cleansing the palate, but that's ridiculous.
You look like a gollywog.
Thanks, Chicky Babe. You want to prop me up on your pillow?
Why, nick off!
Will you shut up? I'm here to serenade you. Chicky Babe, just make out the check for me, will you? Benita couldn't make it.
Wayne, you can't even play that thing.
Who says I have to? You know, I saw this ad on TV. For a special deal, $69.92, I got the violin, the tape music, plus a veggie peeler.
Why are you wearing that stupid hat?
I'm not wearing a hat.
Is this your idea of a romantic evening?
Oh, look, sorry to interrupt, trainee Junior Chicky Babe, but... Just let the music carry you away.
Tracy, just give him 50 bucks and tell him to get lost.
You shut up, you're ruining the whole atmosphere here. The music's about to start.
Hi, I'm Pete Smith. Congratulations. This is a good multi-purpose vegetable peeler.
Hello, your
vegetable
this is peeler not the tape for young horny lovers. Oh, no, they ripped me off.
Loudmouth lime, Flaggot Scarlet.
I can't mind the Pete Smith.
Lime? You can't mind them anyway. Man, they want live music. God, Jody, what do you want to hear?
No, Bobby, thanks.
No problem.
Sorry about the
small
misunderstanding. Thanks for the meal.
I've got a couple of free on the kitchen.
You shut up! Please, will you all just shut up? Do you think Jody's enjoying this?
Of course not. She's gone.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. You've just ruined the best night of my whole life.
Tracy put Ajax on your fettuccine? That is so embarrassing! And then that sleaze Wayne came in with a violin and a wig. Seriously, Anna, I don't know how you can live in this place.
Oh!
And then Bobby started playing something on his guitar. I think it was a song he wrote himself.
Oh, look, I'm so sorry. It's all my fault. Thomas is such a cretin.
Well, Thomas wasn't too bad. But you said it would be okay, and it was totally, absolutely, 100% awful.
Well, look, I'll do anything, but just please don't tell anyone at school, okay? Promise?
I'm just going to go and use your bathroom.
Wasn't what she expected, was it?
Oh, brilliant! You must be starting to learn something about women, Thomas.
Jody must think I'm the biggest dork on earth.
So you did learn something from tonight. Congratulations!
I suppose you're glad that you were right all along?
No, I am not glad. Now Jody thinks I'm as stupid as you. And she's right. I should never have let you go through with this. You weren't emotionally prepared.
It's getting pretty late. I think I should go home now.
Okay, well, Jody, I think we've all learnt a very important lesson from tonight.
Thomas, would you mind walking me home?
Sure. Yeah, that'd be great. Just get my my jacket.
What are you doing? You don't have to be nice to him.
Thomas is still interested, isn't he?
What?
Because I've discovered something about your brother, Anna. He's very intelligent and sensitive. Are you ready, Thomas?
Yeah. Let's go. Oh, by the way, Anna, blondes have equal intelligence to brunettes, redheads, and all other creeds, religious types, and races.
Oh, and Thomas wants to use hairspray.
No. I reserve the right to use hairspray in the privacy of my own home.
Point taken.
Exactly.